유선이라고 하는 것은 바로 인간의 과거의 경험이고 또 기억이자 당시에도 그 사회가 살아가야 하는 하나의 수단과 자원이었고 오늘날에는 우리가 살아가야 할 자원입니다. 그리고 각 집단의 문화정체성을 표현하고 글로벌 사회가 반드시 지켜야 할 문화다양성의 기반이라고 생각합니다. 다음 슬라이드. 한국에서도 무형문화유산에 대해서 오랫동안 관심을 가지고 보존 노력을 해왔습니다. 이제 20년을 넘은 전통문화대학교에도 무형문화유산 전공이 생기고 유네스코의 아태 무형유산센터가 활약하고 있습니다. 오늘 이 자리에 있는 것도 한국의 그러한 노력에서 유래된 것이라고 생각합니다. 이러한 한국의 노력이 아시아 태평양 지역 사회의 문화적 풍요성 그리고 삶의 번영을 이룩하는 데 기여하기를 바라마지 않습니다. 다음 슬라이드. 무형문화유산의 보존은 현대와 같이 빠르게 변화하는 사회에서는 사라지기 마련입니다. 그래서 글로벌 사회는 가지고 있는 자원이 바로 인류의 보편적인 역사의 한 부분이라고 생각하여 잘 보존하고 미래의 우리 삶에 대비하는 자세가 필요할 것입니다. 그래서 보존의 방안을 강구하는 것이 시급한 일이며 보존은 바로 그 전통이 오늘날의 우리의 삶 속에서 살아서 다양한 모습으로 나타나게 만드는 것이 보존의 필수적인 전략일 것입니다. 다음 슬라이드. 아시아 태평양 지역은 문화적으로 연속성, 즉 공통성이 있고 다른 한편으로는 각 문화별로 고유한 개성을 가지고 있습니다. 이것은 이 지역의 인간의 역사가 긴 시간 동안 서로 영향을 주고받은 결과일 것입니다. 사람이 이동하고 문화가 전파되어 지역의 고유한 전통 문화와 새로이 도입된 문화가 융합되어 새로운 고유한 문화를 발전시켜 온 것입니다. 오늘의 주제인 오칠은 아주 대표적인 아시아 태평양 지역의 문화의 공통성과 지역성을 잘 보여주는 하나의 사례라고 할 수 있습니다. 중국의 대칠, 일본의 우루시, 한국의 오칠, 태국의 산마이 등등의 다양한 이름으로 불리고 독특한 모습을 가지고 있지만 오늘날 모두 오칠의 한 종류입니다. 자, 그렇다면 오칠을 어떻게 보존하고 발전시키는 것이 아스팍 지역의 공동 숙제이자 전략이 될 수 있을까요? 아시아 태평양 지역에서는 온나무가 널리 퍼져 있습니다. 그래서 옷봉에는 정착 생활이 시작되는 신석기 시대부터 있었을 것입니다. 이러한 사실은 이미 고고학 유적에서도 확인되었습니다. 양자강 유역의 유명한 허무투 신석기 유적에서 옷으로 가공한 나무글씨 발견되고 또 부분의 유적에서 또 배가 발견된 적이 있습니다. 이 옷봉에는 And this type of lacquer craft has began in the start of China, and then it has flourished during the Han Dynasty, and Korea, Japan, and Vietnam has enjoyed this lacquer culture with the expansion of Han and its cultural diffusion to the regions. We've also seen this expand from Thailand as well as Myanmar, but what we can say is that lacquer, starting from the Neolithic age, probably has flourished altogether around the world. Lacquer is about processing wood to create furniture as well as dishware, but that is not all. It's also used as adhesives and also used to find a way to reduce humidity, and it can also be used for medicine. Therefore, lacquer trees that surround villages is a bit sensitive because it may lead to rashes. However, we do understand that there were many areas where it was applied. So in the Asia-Pacific region, I believe that the lacquer culture indicates a creative a culturalization of different and unique technical artistic developments of the lacquer culture. This is a picture of the lacquer tree. This is a distribution of the toxic conundrum, the poison ivy. And you also see the map of China, as well as the topology of China. And in such a circumstance, we've seen various artifacts. The oldest evidence of Oche at the Neolithic site, and it was used as adhesives. Ever since people started to settle, ever since we've seen Neolithic sedentism, it was important that the people understood the plants and the trees surrounding them, and I think that that has led to a type of lacquer culture to flourish. We've seen a diversity in lacquer crafts, and in Asia Pacific, you can see that it takes on various form and shape. If you look at the left, this is the Dajeon Chilgi of Korea, and you see in the center is China's example, where it has a very thick lacquer layer to create a dishware. And we have urushi, the box of Japan, which is very fancy, and we see the lacquer craft of Myanmar. And not only that, we see an icon of St. Mary's during the medieval times. This indicates that lacquer was used around the world in our everyday lives, and it was also used for decorative artwork. Next slide, please. As I have already mentioned, lacquer craft is a combination of science, technology, as well as arts. There was a scientific mystery of conserving organic material. It also had to do with moisture control, antibacterial components, adhesives, and also was noted to prevent electronic waves. It has a shining and smooth texture, surface, and culture for artistic expression. And that has led to the high society utilize this material in their everyday life and their living arts. It was highly appreciated by that high society. The next slide indicates an artifact, a mummy that was found in the Sanxi region of China. You can see that it's very well preserved, and we were able to understand that lacquer was used to preserve this mummy. As far as I know, even the blood vessels were preserved in its original form. It's also used for these items and the personal equipment at war. And the Hangchir type of attire was found in Korea. Not only that, there are medicinal purposes to lacquer. If we look at the Encyclopedia of Korean Medicine in the past, not only that, it is very articulate in various artwork because it enhances the functionalities of the product itself, and it can also make it beautiful. The way back, lacquer was noted as a mysterious material that would enhance any particular item or aspect of that product. There is something that we really need to note in lacquer artwork, which has to do with the process of producing the product. You can see that there are various ways to produce and to extract the sap, and there is an overall chain that enables these lacquer work to be put together. And you can see that it involves various genres, and we can also say that it's a comprehensive form of art that involves various disciplines, and it also expands. It also expands the scope of art artwork. And it's also a type of traditional culture. And in this vastly changing modern society, sometimes it can disappear, it can be eliminated. Therefore, I believe that it's important to understand that this is a critical element of our modern society, and we have to respond accordingly. And conservation and preservation is something that has to be a part of our everyday life, because it's about preserving the form of cultural heritage to move on and to diversify. The Asia-Pacific region has many commonalities, but it also has regional uniqueness. For a very long period of time, it has impacted each other's cultures, and that has led to creating a very unique form of culture. So in the case of lacquer, we can see that there are both a commonality as well as a diversity amongst the regions. There's also a uniqueness aspect to it. So as cultural heritage of humanity, we need to understand and we need to identify ways to preserve such cultural heritage.
Sorry, I lost it.
So, in the future, I believe that it's important to add additional functionalities to lacquer to have it preserved in the modern society. So, it's important to understand the characteristics of lacquer, meaning that we need to find a way to analyze the material and to expand the applications of lacquer. I believe that this is a key strategy going forward so that we can use this in our modern society. We can expand the applications, which will help it live on. And not only that, lacquer, or 옷질, as we call it in Korea, can be a new art form. It can be used in art, in the arts, to have it be promoted in the value that it can provide to humanity. So I believe that we need to find a way to specialize this particular material or resource. And if you refer to the slide, could you please pull up the slide with the circles? I believe it's page 13. And if you look at this slide, in the modern society, we can utilize lacquer in many ways. We can, of course, traditionally we used it as adhesives, as dishware. However, in the future, in the modern society, I think that there are many ways to utilize lacquer. We need to find a strategy to diversify the applications of lacquer. And this also has to do with finding a way to converge these different lacquer cultures and to develop this into a new type or a new form. Not only that, it's also about applying 옷 or lacquer to new modern cultural forms. Therefore, the functions that were used, or in other words, the applications in the past, can be modified in the future. And I believe joint research on ways to expand the application that befits the demands of the modern society is something that can be very useful. And based on such research, we can enable this culture to expand in Asia. And it can be unfamiliar to those in the Western world. And what I want to say is, because this is a beautiful type of cultural heritage, we can have new markets open, especially in the West. So understanding and identifying new cultural demand and to make inroads into the markets in the West can be something that we can tap into in the Asia-Pacific. These lacquer artwork and craftwork is therefore something that needs to be preserved. We need to find a way to engage in cultural convergence to create new forms, new modes, and also create new demand. It also has to do with creating new forms of this artwork and this heritage. Academic seminars can be key. We can exchange information in the process. And not only that, expos or exhibitions can also be a good channel to bring together many people and to showcase the lacquer culture, to have it receive the limelight. We can share information and also create new ideas in these venues and platforms. And that's why I want to suggest expos and exhibitions on lacquer. It has a scientific merit to it, and there's also an aesthetic aspect to lacquer. And these can be brought together to create a new type of global culture. I believe this is the right strategy forward. And because it's a common culture of the Asia-Pacific and because it has its uniqueness, if we understand ways to do this, it can be a great way for us to expand this culture around the world. Next, I would like to move on to slide 15. This is the Dongyang Uchil Museum, and Professor Kim Sung-soo is front of this painting using lacquer. Professor Kim Sung-soo is very well known as a lacquer artist. He's trying his best to expand this culture around the world. And what you see here in the middle is how lacquer can be used in our everyday life. There are many applications, and one is in the elevator. You can see that Mother Pearl is used in this lacquer artwork. It's about embedding lacquer to our everyday life. How can we do this better? Is something I hope we can discuss at this seminar, because it is something that's necessary to preserve lacquer heritage going forward. Once again, uchir, or lacquer art, is unique to Asia. It is a type of high-end culture that impacts our everyday life as well as the arts, and we can also call it an iconic cultural heritage of Asia, and it also has to do with a universal cultural heritage that impacts the Asia-Pacific. Preserving such culture and developing this culture is key because it can create jobs in this digital world. And not only that, it can enhance our quality of life. We can see that this is a traditional culture that involves scientific techniques. Once again, uchil arts has its own uniqueness depending on the country, but once again, we can say that this is an icon of Asian-Pacific cultural tradition and diversity. In creating an inclusive society in this global world where inclusion is key, I think that uchil offers an important message of cultural diversity and prosperity, which is very well aligned with today's seminar. Uchil arts will open up a new frontier, and for those that are tired of the digital world, uchil, or the lacquer arts, will be providing a new sentiment to the world's people. So with that, let me conclude my presentation. Thank you very much for the invitation. Thank you, Professor Choi Kong-ho and Director General Kim Ki-young for the invitation, and I wish you the best of luck.
Thank you very much.